Good morning, I am Riccardo Ciuscilloni of the University of Cagliari. Now I will speak about Tumuli and peristalites in prehistoric Sardinia. On the island of Sardinia, in the western Mediterranean, archaeological investigations since 800 have revealed the presence of several megalithic monuments of prehistoric times. The first travel scholars who visited Sardinia at the turn of the 19th and 20th century, such as the Scottish archaeologist Duncan Mackenzie and the Irish scholar Olivia Davies, remained so impressed and admired by such a rich megalithic heritage that they reported and described dolmens and menhirs, as well as nuraghi and giants' tombs, Sardinian monuments of the Bronze Age. Numerous scholars, for example Antonio Taramelli and Giovanni Liliu, later occupied the argument, reporting and studying the various monuments as they were discovered. In Sardinia, the megalithic phenomenon is documented at least since the Middle Neolithic Age, 50 millennium BC, reaching its peak during the Late Neolithic and the Copper Age, first centuries of the 4th and end of the 3rd millennium BC, and further developing until the Bronze Age. In fact, we know about 250 dolmenic burials, about 2,500 menhirs, 250 statue menhirs, and at least 20 megalithic circles, or tromlech. The dolmenic tombs are particularly interesting. As we have already said, we currently know about 250 dolmenic monuments of various types: simple dolmens, dolmens with access corridors, alcoves. The dolmens are largely situated in the central northern area of the island. In the southern part of Sardinia, in fact, there are only a dozen of dolmenic monuments. We can find them both on the coast. At Dorgali in northeastern Sardinia, they are located in some cases just a few hundred meters from the sea, and above all in inland areas. The favorite morphological environment is the plateau, followed by hill areas, environments with a pastoral economy. Many of them are closely related to natural trails, sometimes coinciding with canyons or valleys. Usually, these dolmens appear in isolation, although in some cases they are grouped in necropolis, where the graves are located a few meters from each other, such as the site of Matalarentu at Suni, in central western Sardinia. Among these structures, the dome of Saccovecca dei Mores, northwestern Sardinia, stands out for its characteristics. It is exceptional for both its size, it is in fact one of the greatest domes in Sardinia, and especially the presence of a slab with a characteristic rectangular access door on the entrance side, placed centrally at ground level, a port de four in French language. This type of entrance allows comparing the monument with numerous continental examples, especially in France and Spain. In various dolmenic monuments of Sardinia, we found other testimonies of a few elements that could in some way connect the world of the sacred and thus have a religious value as cap marks and linear grooves. Such elements appear mostly on the cover table of the dolmens, but sometimes they are on one of the orthostats or even in the immediate vicinity, on boulders, or on the surface rock. The idiom of these small cavities and grooves may be magic soccer, and in the case of cup marks on the upper surface of a cover plate, they could serve for libation or small sacrifices. There is no data to understand whether these elements of worship were used before the construction of any mound, or if the presence of cup marks and grooves means that in some cases the Dolmenca table was not completely covered by the mound, but it should remain open air. There are also examples of decoration engraved on the dolmens, especially on the upper surface of the cover table. For example, in the monument of Serresa at Sindia in Southwestern Sardinia, and in the dolmen of Sucresto Covercado at Torralba in Northwestern Sardinia. Even though the size of the Sardinian dolmen is generally not so great, many of them are of small size, they are visible in the landscape. While across the European continent many dolmens are still covered by a mound of earth and stones, in Sardinia, however, we have no examples of dolmens in which the tumulus structure has been preserved intact, although in a few cases there seems to be a trace of it. The clearest example concerns the alcove of Sacorteno near Laconi. Here there are still traces of a mound of earth and stones that rests on the slabs that delimit the gallery for at least 1 meter of residual height. A particular case of a kind of a tumulus can be seen in the Ladas dolmen near Luras. Here, instead of the classic mound of stones and earth that covers the dolmen construction, there is a series of 9 flat and thin slabs, inclined and leaning against the monument itself, which constitute a kind of a containment wall. A similar example can perhaps be found in the dolmen of Cucchiarvara at Dorgali, where a vertical slab placed a few centimeters from the perimeter of the room, well worked on surface, rests on the edge of the covering slab. Likewise, all around the Mezzuserra dolmen near Berchida, there are a series of slabs more or less worked, resting on the orthostats, which must have constituted a kind of a tumulus structure. Some dolmens then are partially underground, although it is not clear whether this is due to the existence of an original mound, largely disappeared, or simply if the dolmen structure was thought of as underground, that is, built inside a large pit, as often it happens in the case of a prehistoric lithic cyst or coffers. For example, the dolmens of Alzoled in Luras, Santa Caterina in Berchida, Dolifechima in Ala Sarde, in Ala dei Sardi, Montelongo of Dorgali, etc. Even the dolmen of Maone, near Benetuti, is partly underground, but this can also be explained by its particular conformation, partly excavated in the rock and partly built with irregular rows of stones that form the upper part of the walls of the room. A particular mention deserves the dolmen of Runal, near Itir. It is an imposing simple dolmen, today only partially underground, whose protective mound is adorned by a large wall with a semi-elliptical plan formed by large boulders arranged in regular rules in Cyclopean technique. We had therefore talk of the only case of a structure of tumulus that has remained almost intact. However, the discovery, following a recent clearing of the area of an exedra on the front, a peculiar element for the of the Bronze Age neolithic giant's tomb, clearly puts this interpretation into question, since the mound could not refer to the original plan of this dome, but the external covering of the restructured giant's tomb. However, we believe that stratigraphic excavations are necessary to resolve this controversial point. We can therefore argue, at the current state of knowledge, that there are very few traces of mounds associated with the dolmens on the island. However, there is indirect evidence of the presence of a tumulus structure of some kind in many Sardinian dolmens, consisting of the presence around these dolmens of a peristalite, a dust, a stone ring that surrounded at a short or medium distance the dolmenic structure, intended to consolidate the periphery of a possible mound. This type of structure is well known on the island, starting from the Middle Neolithic phases with the Limuri necropolis in Arzachena, northeastern Sardinia, where peristalites surround some cist tombs. As for the dolmens, there are at least 75 dolmens that retain traces of this peristalite. The peristalite was usually formed by small and medium-sized boulders and had a circular plan, as for example in Motorra near Dorgali, elliptical or semi-elliptical plane, dolmen comis at Buduzo. Sometimes it was formed by two almost concentric circles, Sayana de Sulaco near Buduzo. If, as it has been said, the peristalite essentially served to externally support a possible protective mound, which has now disappeared, a symbolic sacral value, however, has also been proposed for them. The archaeologist Bernd Aragon, in fact, has proposed that such peristalites may have had the function to delimit, as an element of enclosure, the grave, and then separate the sacred world of the dead from the world of the living. In this case, the peristalite should be considered as an element of worship. However, it is also possible that some Sardinian dolmens may have always been without mounds, especially in the case of great monuments such as Sacovecada of Mores, or when there are cap marks and grooves on the upper surface of the covering table. On the island, there are also other types of prehistoric tombs enclosed within a continent circle, which suggests that existence of a mound. Significant examples are found in the necropolis of Cranumoteddu near Goni in southeast Sardinia, datable to the late Neolithic and early Copper Age. The archaeological area consists not only of the necropolis but also of the remains of a village and a notable number of menhirs was the subject of exploration and scientific excavation by Enrico Azzeni of the Cagliari University. The necropolis shows different types of tombs built with the local sandstone. All tombs are characterized by the presence of circular containment structures, usually consisting of two or three circular and concentric alignments of boulders, sometimes even with a stepped structure. Access to the interior was allowed by corridors formed by blocks fixed in the ground, surmounted by horizontal roofing slabs. The structures differ instead in the internal layout, with different types of funeral chambers placed in the center of the circular peristyle, diversified in shape and size. There are quadrangular lithic cysts, chambers with one or two cells, rounded or elongated, with dry stone masonry walls. The great tomb, known as of the chief, differs from this for its importance and its monumentality. Two enormous blocks of stone were used to build it, moved on site from an as yet unspecified location, and resting on a carefully prepared embankment. A corridor with masonry walls leads to the first block, dug inside and finally finished, constituting the antechamber. The second boulder follows, also carefully excavated inside, placed in the center of intermediate compartments arranged radially, delimited by dividing slabs. The tomb, at the entrance of which there is a small menhir, is still partially covered by a circular stepped structure, with a diameter of over 40 meters, surrounded in turn by a further large circle with a diameter of about 35 meters. To conclude, the problem of the absence of mounds in relation to the Dominican burials of Sardinia still remains an enigma. In fact, we don't know for certain whether Sardinian dolmens lacked destruction, contrary to similar monuments in other countries, or whether there is a lack of knowledge due to both the action of atmospheric agents, which sometimes manifest themselves very violently in the highland, both to the destructive work of man, in addition to the fact that other Dolmenic construction with the mounds could still be hidden under the earth that covered them for millennia. The extreme scarcity of these protective structures in Sardinia, therefore, can only cause astonishment if you think, above all, that in France or England or in other countries they appear almost systematically. Only the continuation of the investigation can provide us with answers to the problem. I concluded. Thank you for your attention.